Hey everyone, it's Tammy from SketchUpForInteriorDesigners.com, and today I want to share with you my favorite way to create baseboards all the way around a space without the use of an extension. And this is my favorite because we can quickly add baseboards and then leave openings for doorways. Now, it'll work with window casing, doorway casing, trim, things like that, but it works especially well for baseboards because of that door opening aspect. I do teach this method in my 3D modeling class, but I wanted to share it here as well because I just love this method so much. I wanted to share it a little bit more widely. So let's go ahead and dive in. First up, I will say that this method is only going to work if you've already taken the time to organize your 3D model. And this is something that I focus heavily in my 3D modeling class is grouping, tag organization, componentizing things. So you can see that as I click on the wall here, you can see the blue bounding box. My door is already part of a group. My windows, everything is either part of a group or a component. And that's super important because if I'm taking the time to draw my baseboards, I don't want my baseboards sticking to something else and having to extract that later. I want my baseboard to be their own group. And that's what I've done over here is I've created a 2D profile. It's its own group so that when I extrude this and make it follow the path around the entire room, it becomes its own group that I can control independent of everything else in the model. All right, let's hop in. So I've got this 2D profile. It's basically a rectangle with a little bit of a curve to it. And I've taken the time to make sure that this entire edge is welded as one piece. So if you've got two pieces, you can right click on them and choose weld edges. And that's because I want it to look nice and smooth when I extrude it this way. All right, so that is already grouped together and put into place into this corner here. Now I need to give it a path to follow using the Follow Me tool. And to do that, instead of just drawing the path using my line tool all the way around this room, I already have that edge within the shape below it. So I'm going to double click into my floor and walls group, my shell group here, and then double click on my floor face. And you can see that the edges all the way around are selected. There's a few things that I don't need. I don't need the floor selected, so I'll hold down shift and deselect the floor. And I also don't need this edge here. It's going to be leading to another space here, and I don't want the baseboard to run across this edge. So I'll also deselect that spacebar and then deselect that. All right, so I've got my path. I'm going to copy, which is Command or Control C, and then hop out of that group this way. Now I'm not in any group. I'm going to set this down right on top by going to Edit, Paste in Place. And now you can see this blue edge all the way around the set of edges that are selected. Now I don't want to deselect those. I want to leave them selected because that is the path that this is going to follow. So with those blue, I'm going to go to Tools, Follow Me, and then usually we would click on this shape here if it were loose, but it's already grouped together. So I'm getting that little no-no sign. But we can still hop in there by right-clicking and choosing Edit Group. And now we're able to click on this face and it follows that whole path all the way around the room there because that was the pre-selected path for it. So you can see it's actually dipping behind these built-ins here, and it's also crossing over this door and this door. So that's where our solid tools come into play. So I'm going to hit spacebar, click out into some white space, and we're going to cut out everywhere we don't want that baseboard to cross over. Let's start with our front door. So first up, I just need to draw another solid. Our baseboard, if we created it correctly, is a solid group. In Entity Info, I can see solid group. I'll minimize that, and I'm just going to draw a box. So R for rectangle, and then push-pull up here. Now, I need it to be the same opening that I would like to cut through. So I'm going to use my push-pull tool, and on each edge, I'm just going to infer to that door opening. And if you're going to plan for casing for later, you might want to add about 4 inches or so to each side. So 4 inches extra, and then 4 inches extra over here. Now I'm going to group this together. 1, 2, 3, right click, make group. Again, entity info, it should say solid group. Our solid tools will only work if you're working with two solid pieces of geometry, a group or a component. Now I'm just going to push this right back here using the move tool, and make sure you run right along the green axis in this case, or the red if you're moving the other way. And now you can see that it's crossing over that baseboard in each spot. Now I need to use the third one in the first column here. So third row, first column, this is called trim. So I'm going to click on trim, and I'll click on the box, and then I'll click on my baseboard. And now if I move my box backwards, you can see that if I hop into that group, it's trimmed everywhere that box was crossing over. And it also got rid of the excess here. So trim works really quickly and nicely to give us an opening for that baseboard so that we can walk through the door and add casing later. If you don't want to add casing, you can always double click and select this face and use the move tool or the push pull tool to bring this back into the edge here, meet up with that edge. Just be sure that you run right along the red axis there, or the green in some cases. I'm going to back myself up because I am going to add casing later. Now that we have one box, we can just use that box again in other spots. So I'm going to move it over here right along the floor. And this one, this door isn't quite as wide, so I'm just going to set it on the corner and then move it 4 inches back this way. So I have a 4-inch gap here. And then I'll just hop in here, use the push-pull to infer right to that door, and bring myself back 4 inches. All right, make sure that I'm crossed over here into the baseboard. Again, the trim tool. Trim, click on your box, and then click on the baseboard. And that should create a nice opening right here for this baseboard. So then we just continue to move throughout the space using the solid tools and the same box, creating openings everywhere there's a door. Now I don't want my baseboard to come over here. My door's a little bit too far back. I don't want my baseboard. I'm not going to have casing on the inside of this closet. So again, I'm going to use my select tool and move this right into place there. And then same thing over here. But in this case, I'll just use my push pull tool. Either way gets you to the same spot. All right, last step, I'm just going to use this box one more time over here, and I'll leave the this alone because by this point you kind of get the idea. I'll do that off screen. So I'm going to use the same box, move it along the floor. Set it right in the corner, and then bring myself back 4 inches, and then double click into it, infer right to the edge of that wall, and then add another 4 inches for that door casing. Last time, use the trim tool. First click on our cube, and then second click on our baseboard. Now once you're done with the cube, you can just delete it. We no longer need that. And now you have baseboard that was quickly brought around the entire space. Now, some buildings may require a couple of different floor faces to create this. You may have to do this a few different times if the building is large in different areas, but this works well in this space. So it's just a combination of creating a group using the Follow Me tool and then the solid tools on everywhere that you don't want your baseboard to cross over. I hope that was helpful. If you want to learn more about using solid tools for these purposes, you can hop over to my 3D modeling class on SketchUp4interiordesigners.com.